Oh, she's dancing.
I'm dancing. I'll dance for food.
You know what? We might be starting to miss the summertime a little bit as we wrap up September already, which
I
can't believe.
The last day of September.
But the food that's available in the fall, and this is my favorite time of year to eat.
Cindy Barberi from Cindy's Table is here with a recipe that takes advantage of the fall harvest.
Absolutely.
And it's good for us. Hi, Cindy.
Hi, Kara.
So it's more than pumpkin in the fall? Is that what you're talking
about? Oh, absolutely.
Right.
I mean, this recipe is amazing. And I have to thank Chef White of East Hartford because I got all the ingredients here today. Also, they sponsored my book, Paleo Italian Cooking, so many of them.
Which is your brand new book.
My brand new book. It'll be out on Tuesday in Barnes & Noble, all the big stores. You can find it, and it's still online on Amazon.
What is paleo cooking, I guess?
So, you know, paleo really mimics the way our ancestors ate. So everything that's natural, you know, farm-raised, you know, vegetables that are grown, you know, right
healthy.
Healthy. Everything is just good for you. No preservatives.
No.
Nothing bad
no
for
grains,
you.
No grains, which seems like paleo Italian would be an oxymoron, but you
know,
figured out how to make
really
a lasagna.
Not. And, you know, when I look back at the way my grandmother cooked for us, we ate a lot of paleo food because we went to the butcher. We had the chickens in the backyard. We had the farm. We had the garden, you know, but we had the pasta and bread, so you can really change things around a little bit to make it amazing, which we are today. So I'm doing my butternut squash lasagna, and you're gonna love this. So we're gonna start with the sauce. Okay?
There's the recipe card right there. That's what you need. You need some butternut squash, butter, garlic, coconut milk, diced tomatoes, basil, sage, sea salt, ground pepper. No pasta involved in this.
No pasta is involved in this. So
everything there sounds amazing.
It does. So I have the pan on a nice medium heat. I'm just gonna add in a little bit of olive oil. And then, Mark, if you want to add one of those little pieces of butter right there that I already cut for you, just grab that. So we want to get that nice and hot. So now I have about a half a cup of onion, which is about a half of a good-sized yellow onion.
Okay.
Chopped up. And then we have about 2 to 3 cloves of garlic. Depending on how much you like garlic, add more. I'm Italian, so I like
a lot of garlic.
Yeah, I like garlic. You know, season it with some salt and pepper. You know, you up the heat a little bit, and we just let that cook for a minute. Okay? Now, while that's cooking, we add in a coconut milk, an entire can, a full fat. You want nice, hearty coconut milk.
Okay.
So you want the full fat stuff.
It's like a coconut milkshake.
Absolutely. And it's actually going to thicken up.
That's sort of in place of maybe, I don't know, the ricotta cheese?
Well, cream, because when you make a bechamel, it has cream and milk in it. So this is really almost like that bechamel.
Okay.
And then a whole can, I just don't want to get a hold of the place, of diced tomatoes and the juices. So you let this
simmer.
I know, this is just so good.
It's like a soup right there.
And then we have our spices. So we have basil, parsley, sage, which really brings you back to Thanksgiving and the fall. So we just add that in there, and that's the sauce. I mean, how easy is this?
Is this your favorite time of year to cook?
I love to cook every time of year, but I do love the
There's
nice
just something
comfort
about
foods.
The season. That's the thing. We want to eat like heavy and
the smell. It's just so amazing. So I already started a sauce. This is what it looks like.
Oh, it smells wonderful.
When it cooks for about 20 minutes. So it's nice and thick.
So how do we get these beautiful slices to make the squash look like a lasagna?
So easy. So this is a butternut squash, okay? So what I do is I cut it in half. Now it comes with a skin on it. Now I already took some of the skin off. So all you do is get a vegetable peeler and it just comes right off.
Okay.
So it's really the easiest way to do it. Just give it a nice grip.
Kara, these things are very dangerous.
I know. I'm going to let Cindy do that. She wants me to slice it though. Okay.
So now if you don't have...
You'll be fine with 9 fingers.
Now this is a mandolin and I love this mandolin from OXO because it is a nice sturdy stand and you also have a nice safety cap because you don't want to hurt yourself. You
safety
can easily
caps are important.
Hurt yourself. But if you don't have a mandolin, that's okay. A nice sharp knife. And you want to make sure it's sharp, so always keep like a nice handy knife sharpener with you because you just want to make sure, because if it's not sharp, when you go to cut it, it's going to fall. You're going to cut your finger off.
Especially because you want it so thin.
Exactly. You want it nice and thin. So, Kara, if you want to try it, go ahead. But
just go like this?
Just go right down. You just want to, you really want to give it a good.
Okay. I'm just being a little nervous. I'm going slow.
And
that's good. You're making me nervous. This is not good.
So,
Kara knives. Go to commercial.
No. So I already did it for you here, Kara.
Thank you. I need to work on the mandolin later.
You just really need to just play around with it. And maybe using something like a zucchini might be an easy way to start learning how to use it.
Start with zucchini.
Start with thin cut zucchini, Kara.
So this is what it looks like when you use the mandolin. It's really easy. It really is. And then with the round pieces, you just want to take out the seeds. And then I like cutting these because sometimes in the lasagna, you want to fill in some holes. So we'll use it, or chop it up and roast it in the oven for another dish later on during the week. You can put this in the baggie and put it right in your refrigerator.
And then do you just layer?
So we're going to do it. So, Mark, why don't you hand me that pan?
All right.
So we have a nice little baking dish.
Yeah.
Okay. And I like to add just a little bit of olive oil at the bottom.
Okay.
Okay.
And we've got a little time left to show people
okay.
how to do this.
So what we're going to do is we can add, I like to add a little bit of this.
Oh, yeah, on the bottom.
Just a little bit
help with the sticking.
Exactly. So we'll just add some of that at the bottom.
But this is all healthy fat for you.
Absolutely. Yeah. Now go ahead and just layer the lasagna. So just like you would a traditional pasta lasagna, like a noodle lasagna. Absolutely. So
you two on each side or something.
Yeah. Okay. And then Mark, there's some spinach. Now what I did was I got a bag of spinach, put in the microwave for about a minute. Just put a layer. Beautiful job.
You could add meat to this if you wanted.
So if you want, you can add meat. You can add some ground sausage, some ground meat, whatever you want.
But now, this is a great vegetarian
look
option.
Look at this.
Yeah, I love
absolutely.
That.
You know, if Ellen DeGeneres is coming to your house for Thanksgiving, she's vegetarian.
Yeah, coincidentally.
So we might want to serve this to her, right? Now another layer, and we just keep going. So we'll have two layers in the oven
the
for 350 degrees for 1 hour, and we have a finished product
right there.
I mean, it doesn't smell so good here in the kitchen today.
The second I walked in this morning.
Everybody is so excited.
Beautiful. Okay, we'll have the recipe and a way to get your book, Paleo Italian
Cooking. Yes, you can go onto my website at cindystable.com. You can go right to Amazon. It's still pre-ordered till Tuesday. It'll be in all the stores. We're very excited.